certain it would be entirely unintentional and no more than normal.
Meanwhile, three of the horses in Britain's show-jumping team arrive at Blackbush Aerodrome. Among them is Fox Hunter, proudly conscious that he'll be carrying our last gold medal hopes. Lieutenant Colonel Harry Llewellyn is there to see Fox Hunter and the team leave on their long flight, and to thank, on behalf of his partner, all those people, including many children, who'd sent them messages of good luck. The Olympic swimming events are well underway, and here's the start of the women's 100 metres freestyle event. In the stands, the Duke of Edinburgh and Prince Bernhard watched the thrilling battle won by Katalin Csoka of Hungary, with Holland second and Hungary again third. 17-year-old Angela Blondwell of Worthing finishes eighth to receive well-deserved applause as a star of the future, while the star of today receives her due as Olympic champion. Jersey reaches another milestone in Channel Island history as it celebrates the golden jubilee of its famous Battle of Flags. It all began 50 years ago on Victoria Avenue, this year's carnival site, and formed part of the coronation festivities of King Edward VII. The same spirit reigns on in 1952, the year of the accession of Queen Elizabeth II, who visited Jersey 3 years ago. We'll be right back. sacred flame died, and the Olympic hymn was heard across the arena for the last time. Pictures of ex-King Farouk of Egypt since his abdication. They show him with his wife, daughters, and the baby son who succeeds him as King Fuad II. The exiled king, to be known in future as Prince Farouk, holds in his arms the future destiny of Egypt's royal house. Argentina was the passing of a national heroine, Eva Perón, wife of the president, as crowds queue to pay homage to her memory at the Ministry of Labor building in Buenos Aires, where her body lies in state. Like many social reformers, Eva Perón came from humble parentage, but marriage to the president of the republic gave her the opportunity to initiate vast schemes for the good of her people. Runway spending a bank holiday is trying to reach the top of the Beeston Castle hilltop. Now it's easy to see why so few riders reach the summit. Like the bank holiday weather, they just keep falling down. So in this jet age, one rider decides to go up that hill like a rocket. Preparations for the coronation are centered upon Westminster, where at Church House, the Minister of Works, the Right Honourable David Eccles, is already planning the great pageant of state. By ancient heritage, England's Premier Duke, the Duke of Norfolk, is responsible for the organisation of the solemn ceremony, while the Minister of Works outlines the facilities his department will provide on this day of national rejoicing.
Welcome them here and to do my main job, which is to define for all the benefit I have what are the duties of the Ministry of Works in the preparations for the coronation. The Minister of Works, that's me. The Minister of Works is the Earl Marshal's handyman. My job is to set the stage, to build a theatre inside Westminster Abbey, to provide seats and standing room, viewpoints, decorations, along that part of the processional route which is crowd funded. Arrange flowers, bank lighting, fireworks, and other expressions of public rejoicing. And on the line of the procession, to take care of the press, broadcasters, and the camera. The great advantage of the coronation route, which Her Majesty has been pleased to approve, it is that the procession will proceed from Buckingham Palace and return to Buckingham Palace by the manor, which all will agree is the finest ceremonial way in London. Our plans for the stands are not quite complete, but I do expect to provide open and covered seats for at least 98,000 people all along these stands that you see on the plan here. Outside the event, on those parts of the route which are crowd funded, the Ministry of Works will provide the press and cameramen facilities to report on photographic procession. Well, ladies and gentlemen, one is very thrilled by seeing this great show for your own eyes. I'm pretty sure that for every 10,000 people who do see the coronation, at least a million will read of it and watch it on the screen. Therefore, I've had the pleasure of it carefully and studied very carefully, all the films and all the photographs made from the population of 1937. And there are many lessons to be learned from these documents. It's quite clear that this time, right from the very beginning, we must plan the scheme of decoration and select the points at which cameras are sighted so that the best pictures can be made. Many of us, when looking at the films, made last time an insufficient profile was given to this question, which is so important. Talking about the coronation, I'd like to end up in this way. I count myself very fortunate to live under the monument. And if I know British work, they are going to spare no pains to make the setting of the coronation worthy of their history. I'm quite sure that the many peoples of the Commonwealth who will be gathered in London next June will vie in loyalty and affection to express their joy to see the Queen crowned and Elizabeth II.
Road users are as guilty of speed teams for the mounting road casualties. It's not always the much maligned motorcyclists either. Opening your outside door without looking while riding bicycles to abreast, each of these thoughtless habits contributes to the annual August toll of nearly 500 deaths. London again.